All right, so let me put this mic right over here. Yeah, so as you can tell, it's lighter because it's actually 5 or 6:23 in the evening. I had to stop recording because I was having a little bit of a bad night with the dog, and then also it's taking forever to upload in here because the router is in another room, which if I was near the router, I would definitely be uploading really quick because some videos have taken like 5 minutes to upload because I think my sister has a 20 megabit per second upload speed and 100 megabit download speed. So yeah, but since I'm not near the router, it's kind of. And plus, I sometimes get a lower signal in here. Like right now, it's got 4 and 5 bars, while last night I was having 2 bars. So don't know what's up with that. So either way, bad night plus horrible upload equals I had to go to sleep before I could type anything in and upload it for the day. So those videos went up yesterday instead of the day before, and this video is going up today because of that. So, but hopefully I can get some more stuff done. So enough chitter chatter. Turn that down first because that was loud in my ears. The court is now in session for the trial of Maya Faye. Also, I was looking at the clock and actually the last recording was like 110 minutes, so that's all gonna be uploaded today and so or yesterday, so I'll have to make probably 3 more videos, which might actually take up this entire thing. So could have this entire thing done by the end of this week for all I know. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor. The defense is ready, Your Honor. Miles Edgeworth. I better not show any signs of weakness today, or he'll be on me in an instant. Yeah, about that. Mr. Edgeworth, please give the court your opening statement. Thank you, Your Honor. The defendant, Miss Maya Faye, was at the scene of the crime. The prosecution has evidence she committed this murder. Also, I find it funny because so many people have said he's not actually English, even though he has that clavette thing, which is more of an English sort of thing, so. And we have a witness who saw her do it. The prosecution sees no reason to doubt the facts of this case, Your Honor. I see. Thank you, Mr. Edgeworth. Let's begin then. You may call your first. They never fixed that in the remake. Okay, that's supposed to be the judge saying that. You may call your first witness. The prosecution calls the chief officer at the scene of the crime, Detective Gumshoe. What am I doing here, pal? Witness, please state your name and profession to the court. Sir! My name's Dick Gumshoe, sir. I'm the detective in charge of homicides, sir, down at the precinct, sir. No pals? Detective Gumshoe, please describe for us the details of this murder. Very well, sir. Let us use this floor map of the office to explain. The body was found at this window here. And the cause of death? Loss of blood due to being struck by the blunt object, sir! The murder weapon was a statue of the thinker found next to the body, sir! It was heavy enough to be a deadly weapon, even in a girl's hands, sir!
Sir, sir, sir. He's saying sir more than pal right now.
The court accepts this statue as evidence. It's not a statue. They're still calling it a statue.
Now, detective.
Yes, sir!
You immediately arrested Miss Maya Fay, who was found at the scene, correct? Can you tell me why?
Yes, sir! I had hard evidence she did it, sir! Detective Gumshoe, please testify to the court about this hard evidence.
Okay.
As soon as the phone call came in, I rushed to the scene! There were two people there already. The defendant, Miss Maya Fay, and the lawyer, Mr. Phoenix Wright, pal. I immediately arrested Miss Maya Fay! Why? We had a witness describing her! The witness saw Miss Maya Fay at the very moment of the murder!
The very moment, you say? Very well. Mr. Wright, you may begin your cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor. Cross-examine what? I couldn't see a single contradiction in that testimony.
Whoosh! Smack!
Hey! Maya just threw something at me. Or more like, threw via paper airplane is what I'm thinking. What's this? When my sister couldn't find any contradictions in a witness's testimony, she would bluff it and press the witness on every detail. One of my favorite things to do! The witness always slips up and says something wrong. It worked lots of times. I should have expected Maya would know some of her sister's tricks. Hey, we already did that. It was kind of funny in the last trial. Also, how does she know about this if she doesn't even know what the hell an attorney's badge looks like? Tell me about that. Alright, let's give this a try.
Something the matter?
No, Your Honor, no paper airplane smacked me in the face. No, nothing at all. Just let's begin the cross-examination, please.
As the phone call came in, I rushed.
Hold it! Who did you say got a call from? And it wasn't a rush. We saw the person call, and then, and it took, like, what, 10 minutes it seemed like?
Hey, pal! Don't play dumb! You know who! The call was from a customer at the Gatewater Hotel, right across from the crime scene! She said that she even saw you! Hey, were you accomplice?
No. Okay, I pressed. Not sure if it did much, though. Right. Please, continue.
There were already two people there! Hold it! Wait! Who are those two people?
Detective Gumshoe, how long did you say it... how long would you say it took between you receiving the call and your arrival at the scene of the crime?
Right. I'd say it was about 3 minutes!
That's pretty fast. I thought it was more like 5 to 10 minutes.
Our motto this month is quick response, pal. That's how I got there before the killer got away, after all.
Indeed. So, tell us who the two people you found on the scene were.
Yes, sir! The defendant, Miss Maya Fay, and the lawyer, Mr. Phoenix Wright. That's you!
Hold it! Are you absolutely sure it was us?
Listen, pal! Your dumb act will only get you so far! With her funky hippie clothes and your spiky hair!
What's wrong with my hair?
You two stand out like suspicious people at a crime scene! Come on, pal!
Well, he does have a point about her.
She is pretty unmistakable. I should pick up my points to press with a little more care.
Hell no! I immediately arrested Miss Maya Fe- Oh, whoa! Hold it!
Why is that? What's your reason?
I love that. Wait. Why? What is that? What's your reason? It just continues into the testimony.
Why? We had a witness account describing her! Hold it!
Hold on just one second.
Yeah?
If I heard correctly...
You said you arrested her because you had hard evidence. She did it, correct?
Huh? Did I say that? Me? Look over there, and look over there, and look up. Ooh.
I heard you say it!
You did say it. You said it.
Exactly what about this suspicious woman in Pink's claim was hard evidence?
What?! Miss May isn't suspicious, and she sure isn't Pink, pal!
She sure looks pink to me.
Well, I guess she is pink. That's enough, Detective Gumshoe. Do you have any more solid proof other than her claims, Detective?
Look over there.
Yeah, look over there. Yes. Up. Oh, what's that on the ceiling?
I guess pressing can have its advantages.
Oh, yes. Sorry. I got the order of things mixed up in my testimony, Your Honor, sir. There's something I should have told you before, Your Honor!
Very well, Detective. Let's hear your testimony again. I mean, after all, police make mistakes. It's the witnesses that shouldn't be making mistakes.
But even then, we give them a chance.
Hard evidence.
After securing the suspect, I examined the scene of the crime with my own eyes! I found a memo written on a piece of paper next to the victim's body! On it, the word Maya was written clearly in blood, sir! Lab test results showed that the blood was the victim's! Also, there was blood found on the victim's finger! Before she died, the victim wrote the killer's name! How you like that? That's my hard evidence!
Say that again.
Hard evidence?
Before we begin cross-examination, I have a question for you, Detective.
Your Honor? Why didn't you testify about this vital piece of evidence the first time?
I know. I'm real embarrassed I forgot about it, Your Honor, sir.
Oh, please don't deduct my payroll. Try to be more careful!
Very well. The defense may begin its cross-examination.
After securing the suspect, I examined the scene of the crime with my own eyes! Hold it!
And did you find any evidence?
Now! Don't jump the gun on me, pal! Just listen! I'm getting to the good part!
I got a bad feeling about this.
I found a memo written on the piece of paper next to the victim's body! Hold it!
Just because you found it next to the body doesn't mean the victim wrote it!
Ho ho ho! Then who did write it, Mr. Smarty Pants?
Who?
I did! It could have been me!
What? So it was you?
No. I'm just saying it could have been me. Can you prove it wasn't?
Objection.
Hold on. I have enough of this little chitter-chatter. So you admit to this? You admit that you wrote the note? Listen to me, Mr. Wright. This is a court of law, and I expect you to refrain from making thoughtless statements.
Amateur? What?
Well, detective, tell us what was written on that memo you found.
Okay. Hold it. I want to see what else. Yeah. It was Miss May that was across from the hotel. Yeah.
Well, it could have been the witness, Miss May.
Objection.
Hold on. The witness was in her hotel room, not the office.
Try pulling the other leg, Mr. Wright. Yeah, and while you're at it, pull mine too, pal.
What? Well, detective, tell us what was written on that memo you found.
Okay, we'll frickin' say the real thing that you should have said.
It was the killer, of course. The killer! Anyone can see that!
Oh! You say the killer wrote her own name? Buddy, please!
She was framed!
Objection.
Hold on. If that's the case, where's your evidence? This is only my second case. I haven't really learned about evidence too much yet. I guess that was a bit of a tall order for you. Those without evidence shouldn't open their mouths, Mr. Wright.
Yeah, pal!
Well, detective, tell us what was written on that memo you found, finally, for the third time!
On it, the word Maya was written clearly in blood, sir! Hold it!
Do you have proof it was Mia who wrote that?
Of course I do, pal!
Uh-oh. He sounded pretty confident. This might not be good.
Lab test results showed that the blood was the victim's! Hold it!
Is that your only evidence? What kind of tests were these again?
Huh? What kind? Well, I'm not really a forensics detective. I hear they take the, little bits in the blood, the,
hobgoblins?
I refuse to testify on this matter, sir! I'm no expert on blood tests!
Yes, that was quite clear. Please, refrain from asking the witness about blood tests, Mr. Wright.
Thanks, pal! I mean, your honor, sir!
Detective Gumshoe?
Yeah?
I think you can expect a pleasant bonus in your next paycheck.
Oh.
That was a mess.
Right! Where was I?
Yes, that was my name.
Also, the blood was found on the victim's finger!
Whoa, hold up! Whoa.
On which hand was the bloody finger, Detective?
The right hand!
Well, she was right-handed.
Ah! Nice try! I know your lawyerly tricks!
Uh-oh. I guess it wasn't too hard to see what I was getting at there.
Before she died, the victim wrote the killer's name! Hold it!
Detective Gumshoe, do you get a lot of cases where the victim actually writes the killer's name?
Sure! Happens all the times in books and the movies!
This isn't a movie, Detective.
Oh, yeah.
Let's talk reality, shall we?
Yeah, I guess. I haven't heard of many cases, no.
Don't you find it a little odd that the victim would write down a name? Especially the name of her own sister?
Yeah, actually, you got a point, pal.
Stop right there. The witness's opinion on this matter is irrelevant. The facts are clear. The victim wrote down the name of the accused.
The victim told us the name of the killer. Order! Order!
That didn't go so well.
That's right! What he said!
Okay, what do we have here? Because it's been about 12 hours or more since I've done this, and I don't remember what the heck I should be doing. Let's see. That's his whole testimony. Okay, there has to be a contradiction in there somewhere. Let's find it. Great. Let's see here. Cause single blunt force trauma. Death was instantaneous.
A contradiction!
Can you tell me how she did that when she was dead? Because, I mean, she died instantaneously, so...
Objection!
Detective Gumshoe, come on! You gave me the autopsy report. There was one thing I want to clarify. I want you to clarify for me here. You say that the victim, Mia Fey, wrote this note. That she was accusing the defendant, Mia Fey? That's really what you're saying?
What? This isn't one of those lawyerly tricks now, is it? Of course she wrote it! Who else could've?
You have it backwards, Detective.
Backwards?
The victim is the only person who absolutely could not have written it. This is a report from your department, Detective. Immediate death due to a blow from a blunt object.
She died immediately! But...
No butting your way out of this one, Detective!
Order! Order! The defense has a point. Someone who died immediately wouldn't have the time to write anything down. They'd be dead!
Mr. Wright, I beg your pardon, but when exactly did you obtain that autopsy report? When? I actually forgot to put my mouse off, sorry. Or did that shake on here whenever I did that? But I forgot. It's been 12 hours, so I'm sorry, I forgot.
Forgot, you say?
It was the day after the murder, Your Honor, sir. I was the one who handed it to him myself, personally!
Oh. Right.
The prosecution's point being
that autopsy report is outdated, Your Honor.
What?!
A second autopsy was performed yesterday, at my request. Death was almost immediate due to a blow from a blunt object.
You just added that word in! Give me a break!
But there is a possibility that the victim lived for several minutes after the blow. I received these results this morning.
No way! No way in hell!
Your Honor, it's quite easy to imagine that the victim did have the time to write Maya. That is all.
I see.
Damn you, Edgeworth! I should have known you'd have something up your sleeve!
Why, Mr. Wright, you look shocked. Something you want to say?
I want to say two answers because... Actually, no, I want to say all of them because it's just funny.
Let's see, from save point.
I'm a sham! Detective Gumshoe, are you calling me a fool because I believed your report?
Huh? Me? I'm not. Huh?
Detective Gumshoe. I'm disappointed in you handing him the wrong report like that.
I'm sorry, sir.
You are at fault, detective. This isn't going to look good on your evaluation next month.
What? But...
Your Honor, I can't go back, okay. I don't feel like resetting, and I know since I did the I'm a sham and apparently the detective's at fault. He's gonna be at fault with the other thing as well. The only time I'm going to get blamed is I'm pretty sure when I say, Edgeworth is a sham!
Understood. The court accepts this, the evidence.
Well, Your Honor, the evidence strongly suggests the victim was identifying the killer.
I suppose that's the obvious conclusion, yes.
Damn! This isn't good!
The prosecution would like to call its next witness. This poor innocent girl saw the murder with her own eyes. Yes. Let me point and wag my finger.
Let the witness, Miss April May, take the stand.
Exactly what part of her is innocent?
Witness. Your name, please?
April May! At your service!
Wink.
Order. An introduction should not require any crowd reaction. The witness will refrain from wanton winking.
Aww. Yes, Your Honor.
This is not good. She's already captured the heart of every man in the court, besides myself! If you look up the, if you look up Phoenix's faces or something, I don't remember where exactly, but I remember seeing that one of his reactions was supposed to be hearts and stuff. So I almost can guarantee that was a beta sort of face, and it was supposed to react with April, May or something, so... Yeah, but they took that out because April, May is crazy. If you didn't know. Considering how she reacted that one time, with the twitching eye and stuff. Tell us, where were you on the night of September 5th when the murder occurred?
Gee, I was like, in my hotel room? Teehee! I checked in right after lunch!
And this hotel is directly across from the Faye & Co. law offices?
That's right, big boy! Yeah, you're a really big boy!
Please testify to the court about what you saw.
Ugh. It was like night at night. I looked out the window, you know. And then, oh! I saw a woman with long hair being attacked! The one attacking her was the mousy girl sitting in the defendant's chair! Then the woman, like, dodged to one side and ran away! But that girl, she caught up to her and she hit her! Then the woman with long hair, she kinda slumped. The end! That's all I saw! Every little bitsy witsy!
Wink.
Well, Your Honor.
I see. It is a remarkably solid testimony. I don't see a need to trouble the witness any...
Wait, Your Honor!
Yes, Mr. Wright.
What about my cross-examination?
I thought the witness's testimony just now was quite firm.
Was that supposed to be a joke?
Didn't you?
No!
Mr. Wright, I understand you were Miss Mia Faye's understudy, were you not? You must know her techniques well. Her cowardly way of finding tiny faults in perfectly good testimonies.
Hey! How dare you!
Well, Mr. Wright, will you cross-examine the witness?
Nah, I'm good. No thanks. No, you're right. I guess there wouldn't be much point.
I'm glad you saw the error of your ways so soon. Your Honor, the prosecution rests its case!
What? That's it?
Very well. Yes, Mr. Wright? Changed your mind? Will you cross-examine the witness?
Actually, on second thought, yeah. Yes, yes, yes! CCC! Hi? I'd better, or I'll lose on the spot!
Very well. You may begin your cross-examination.
Hi.
It was like night at night! I looked out the window, you...
Why the hell did you look out the window right at 9? Oh, it's 9 o'clock! I'd better look out the window! Oh my god, a killing!
Why the hell did you do that?
Huh? Why? Like, why what?
Why did you look out the window? Were you expecting to see something? There wasn't an eclipse happening that night.
Oh, well, gee! Look at the time!
What? That's it?
She can't get out of this question that easily!
sort of, you know. I had a feeling!
Gee, April May is a psychic now, folks. Give it up for her. Well, I have a feeling she's trying to avoid the question.
Maybe I should press a little harder on this one.
Go for it!
Let's see how far I can run with this. Surely you must have had a reason to look out the window at that time at night.
Mr. Wright, I will not have you badgering my witness.
Aw, but I like badgering.
Badgering? Badgering? Look at her face! I just asked that question the second time because she didn't give me a straightforward answer, and look at her face!
It worked in the first case.
That kind of rhymed.
You insist on needing her wit. You insist on needling her with these trivial questions.
Trivial questions? Are you out of your mind?
I really don't think it should be allowed.
Yeah, stop it! The poor girl! Order!
Mr. Wright, you have been warned.
Poor girl? What about poor me? I have to take care of a dog that likes to freaking chew on rugs!
You looked out the window. What did you see next?
And then... Oh! I saw a woman with long hair being attacked!
Hold it!
The woman with long hair. Was that Mia Faye?
Slender, sort of, well, some people might say pretty if that's your thing.
Your thing?
And the person attacking her?
The one attacking her was that Mousy's girl sitting in the defendant's chair over there!
Hold it!
How do you know she was the defendant?
Well, you know, she had a girlish physique. Women know these sorts of things, yeah. Look, I just know, okay?
There was only one person at the scene of the crime with a short girlish figure. That wouldn't happen to be you, Mr. Wright, would it?
The testimony is bulletproof, Your Honor.
He's right.
Yep, he's right! Yep! What shall I do besides knock my mic over? I question the testimony! Hold on a minute! That testimony stinks!
Like the frickin' shower, like the tap water over here. Smells like rotten eggs, stinky.
What?!
Have to frickin' get a shower once a day because I can't stand the smell of the water.
You're lying, damn it! And I approve it!
Somehow.
Are you telling the truth? Did you really see the defendant?
Mr. Wright, what's the meaning of this?
Yes, what is the meaning? Somebody tell me because I'm clueless. About this, I mean! He's being a meanie!
Okay. If you really had witnessed my client, Mia Faye,
you would have noticed her clothes before noticing her physique!
No one wears clothes like this on a daily basis! Except her! And I'm no expert on fashion, but her hairdo looks far from normal to me. No offense, Maya. However, the witness's testimony mentions neither of these things!
The testimony is bogus! B.O. bogus!
But...
Still, we don't know if she was dressed that way the night of the murder.
She was, Your Honor. I was there! Hell, Detective Gumshoe was there! She's been in the same clothes for the past 2 days! And exactly! What do you say about that, Miss Faye?
Rawr! What are you trying to say, you mean, mean lawyer? I saw what I saw! I just didn't think all the trifling little details were necessary, darling!
Darling! Miss May.
Look at the eyes on him. He looks very, very angry right now.
The court would like to remind you to please omit nothing in your testimony.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. I'll be a good girl. I promise.
Wink.
Your
excuse me. Your testimony again, if you would.
Damn! I almost had her!
I did see everything! I did it! The victim, the woman, dodged the first attack and ran off to the right! But the girl in the hippie clothes ran after her! And she hit her with that weapon! I saw it! I did! I did throw a putty tack! That clock! The kind of statue-y clock? The thinker, I think? Well, does the accuracy of my report not startle you? Teehee!
Yeah, kind of a little too accurate, wouldn't you say?
I see. I only wish you had been so detailed at the beginning. Please begin the cross-examination.
I did! I did talk, Putty Tat! I did!
Wait. Hold it! What, Putty Tat? So, you saw me then too? Like, you kind of looked kind of spastic there.
Of course! I'd remember that spiky hair anywhere! Jeez, what kind of hairstyle is that?
Spiky?
The witness will refrain from personal attacks on the defense attorney.
Ah, was I a bad girl? I'm sorry!
Very well. Continue.
The victim! The woman! Dodged the first attack and ran off to the right!
Oh, whoa! Is that right as in your right? As he looked from the hotel?
Which hand do I hold my knife in again? Right! It was my right hand! Right?
By the way, I have it mirrored, so my right is your right, so...
Satisfied, Mr. Wright? Please continue.
Then the girl in the hippie clothes ran after...
Hold it! So now you talk about the convenient... How convenient for you to remember her hippie clothes, yeah.
That's what she was wearing! Oh, and her hair was all done up like a bun!
What happened then?
And she hit her with that weapon! I saw it! I did! I did saw a putty tat!
Hold it! What's this putty tat you're talking about?
Where did this weapon come from?
She picked it up from her desk!
I see. What sort of weapon was it?
Statue clock? The tinker I tink?
Hold it! Clock?
Didn't this come up in another testimony recently?
Well, don't look so sour, Mr. Lawyer! You can't win them all!
No, but I have a feeling I'm onto something now. I guess that's it, so...
OBJECTION!
Miss... May... What you said just now was quite... revealing.
Revealing? Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? Naughty Mr. Lawyer!
You just said this statue of the Thinker was a clock. But there's no way of knowing that just by looking at it! Another person in much the same position as you recently called this a clock, too. And he was found guilty
of murder. Ooh.
Order! Order! There will be no threats in my courtroom, Mr. Wright. Miss May, can you explain how you know this was a clock?
The witness saw the murder with her own eyes. That's all that's important here.
The defense is trying to confuse the issue with trivial concerns.
Yes. Yes, of course. You will withdraw your question, Mr. Wright.
Hold it! Objection! But questions are all I have, Your Honor!
And as you may recall, I've caught murderers with these questions before. Well, one.
Objection sustained. You may continue to question the witness.
Well, that was easy. Phew! That was close. If he stopped me there, the trial would be over!
Huh? What? So, what happens now?
I continue to question you! Isn't that fun?
What happens now is you answer my question, damn it! How did you know it was a clock?
What? I heard it? Yes! I heard it say the time!
You heard it. From across, like, from one building to the other?
What?
So you've been to the law offices of Faye and Co. because that's the only way you should have heard it?
No! Hey, I didn't say that! Why would I go there? I don't need an attorney! I heard from my hotel room! Hee hee!
The law offices of Faye and Co., where the murder took place, are very close to the hotel.
Are you freaking insane?
She could have easily have heard the clock.
Well, Mr. Wright, are you satisfied?
Hell no! I can't give up now! I'm not satisfied because she couldn't have heard it! And it couldn't have wrong. Both of these are actually really good, but I'll go with they couldn't have wrong.
Your Honor, members of the court,
it is inconceivable that the clock in question rang because...
the batteries are dead.
The batteries on the clock must be dead!
Must be, Mr. Wright?
Your Honor, if you would inspect the clock...
Very well.
Oh!
Well, Your Honor,
are they dead?
The clock has greater problems than dead batteries, Mr. Wright. This clock is missing its clockwork! It's quite empty!
Oh man, I needed a drink. But I almost drank wrong too.
Mr. Wright, would you care to explain to the court what is the meaning of this?
It is as you can see. The clock was empty. It couldn't have rang. Therefore, this witness is a big, fat, phony!
Fat!
Well, Miss May? Quite a show you've put on for us, Mr. Wright. He knew the clock was empty. Somehow, he knew.
No, not this music! Well, he's got me on the ropes!
I'm afraid you've forgotten one thing, however. Indeed, the clock is empty, as you say. It can't ring. However, we must ask, when was the clockwork removed? If it was after the witness heard the clock, then there is no contradiction.
That's true. That is a possibility. The clock might have been emptied after she heard it.
And that is exactly what happened, Your Honor.
What?
Well, Mr. Wright, can you prove when the clockwork was removed?
Oh, impossible!
Of course! I have proof!
What?!
Wasn't it you who told me proof is everything? Well, I was listening, even if I have headphones on.
And now I'll show you the proof you like so damn much!
The evidence that proves when the clockwork was removed is...
What do you say to that?
What? I don't rightly understand what that's supposed to mean.
I don't rightly understand either.
Uh-oh, I think I blew it.
Mr. Wright, please refrain from flippant presentations of evidence in the future.
Sorry, Your Honor.
The evidence that proves when the clockwork was removed is... on my pink cell phone!
Or is it purplish?
Take a look at this!
Get a load of this! That's a very cute cell phone, Mr. Wright. Is it yours?
You have a girly phone!
Wait! This isn't my phone! Listen!
This is the defendant's cell phone, and it contains a recording.
A recording of a conversation she had with the victim on the day of the murder.
Order! Order! The defendant's cell phone? This wasn't brought to my attention!
Perhaps Detective Gumshoe kinda sorta overlooked it? The good detective better remember he's for evaluation soon! My heart goes out to you, Edgeworth.
Not!
Let's hear the conversation. So you just want me to hold on to the thinker for you then? If you could. I should probably tell you, the clock isn't talking right now. Huh? It's not working? That's lame! I had to take the clockwork out. Sorry. Your Honor, I rest my case. I think this recording makes it clear that the clockwork was already gone. In this recorded in the morning, before the witness even arrived at her hotel. Well, Miss Faye, would you care to explain this to the court?
Just how did you know that the weapon was a clock?
Well, isn't it obvious? I saw that clock before!
Jeez, you never give up.
What store was that again? I go to so many! Oops, I forgot!
Wink. So the witness had seen it before. That would make sense. Does the defense have any objections, Mr. Wright?
Yes. Yes, I do.
No. She saw it as sore. Oh, right. Well, if she had seen it before, I guess.
Wait a second!
Then the court would like...
Hold on! Please wait, Your Honor. I spoke out of term.
Yes, you do have an objection?
Yes, well...
Mr. Wright!
Sorry, Your Honor. It's just, the witness claims she had seen it before.
But this directly contradicts a piece of evidence already submitted to this court!
Well then, let's see it. Please produce this evidence that will prove the witness had not seen this clock before.
Take that!
It's simple! This clock was never in any store ever!
What?!
A friend of mine made the clock. Only two exist in the world. And the one that isn't here is in police custody.
Impossible! Everything is sold in stores!
You need to get out more.
Miss May, I think it's high time you went shopping for... I don't know.
A better excuse?
Yeah!
Oh? Excuses not for sale today?
What's it to you, porcupine head? That stupid clock doesn't matter, okay? She did it, and she should die for it! Die!
Whoa! Let's not get ahead of ourselves here. This is a court of law, and the witness will remain calm.
Silly me! Did I, lose it? I guess I did.
Wink. Scary. Miss May. Let me ask, tell me, how did you know the weapon was a clock?
Your Honor, can I get permission for the witness to stop giving me the death glare?
Oh dear.
That's all he has to say is, oh dear.
Does the defense have an opinion on this behavior?
Okay, this is it! Yes, Your Honor. Allow me to explain how I see the truth of this matter. Miss April May, you knew the weapon was a clock because you had heard about it. The witness had never held the clock in her hand. However, she had heard that it was a clock.
She heard?
That is correct, Your Honor. There is no other way she could have known the thinker was a clock. I mean, after all, she was in the hotel at the time of the murder.
And I can show you the proof!
Well, this is getting very interesting. Let's see it then. Show me the evidence proving that the witness had heard the murder weapon was a clog.
This piece of evidence right here. Have a look at this. Do you know what this is? I found this in Miss May's room.
Mr. Wright, please explain to the court what this is.
Miss April May,
you were tapping the victim, Miss Mia Faye's phone, were you not?
Your Honor, this is irrelevant.
I'm not entirely sure that it is.
Objection overruled.
It troubles me that our witness was in possession of a wiretap.
This is outrageous! Does the defense truly claim that the witness was tapping her phone?
Absolutely I do!
Even if that was the case, which is not, let me remind everyone, you still have one thing to prove!
Did the victim ever say that the weapon was a clock on the phone?
Can you prove that? I think not!
Oh yeah? I think I can! It's simple!
What?
Here's my proof.
The proof that the victim said on the phone that the weapon was a clock is the freaking phone, you idiot!
I present the defendant's cell phone again!
Yes, we've seen that already.
Listen once more to the conversation between the defendant and the victim.
Mia, what's up? You haven't called in a while. Well, actually there's something I want you to hold on for me. Again? What is it this time? It's a clock. It's made to look like that statue, the Thinker, and it tells you the time.
Miss April May,
you used a wiretap to listen to this conversation!
That's how you knew the Thinker was a clock!
Am I wrong?
Your Honor, this is ridiculous!
Your Honor, look at the witness's face! Does she seem amused to you?
I love using that excuse all the time.
The defense demands an answer!
La! La! La!
Witness? Answer the question. Did you tap her phone?
Miss May!
Shut up! All of you! What gives you the right to talk to me like that? You lawyer! It's no fair! All of you keep ganging up on me like that! Oh, I'm the bad girl? Is that it?
Well, wiretapping is kind of illegal.
That did it! The court's seen the real Miss May, April May, now.
Now to deal the final blow. You did it, didn't you? Come on, that's a stupid thing.
Why the wiretap? Why did you tap her phone?
Answer the question.
Do I have to?
Yes.
Isn't this a murder trial? Isn't tippity-tapping irrelevant?
Yes! That's what I've been trying to say all... Objection! Let the witness state why.
Yeah, she's saying exactly what Edgeworth wants her to say. Miss May, you were tapping the victim's phone.
I hardly call that irrelevant, considering the victim is dead.
While this court does not condone the defense's tone of speech, he does have quite the point.
Well, Miss May, do you have an explanation for the court? Can you prove you had nothing to do with this murder, even though you tapped her phone?
Ha! I'd like to see her pull that off!
Mr. Lawyer, I saw that evil grin! You were probably thinking, I'd like to see her pull that off, weren't you?
Damn, she's good.
Now you're not the first man who's thought that, and of course, I can and will!
You can't be serious. No way!
Way, I say! Way, way, way! Oh, and I assure you I'm serious, Mr. Lawyer. Okay, so the killing happened around 9 at night. Why, that's just when I was getting room service from that sweet, sweet bellboy.
Room service?
Iced coffee, I believe it was. Iced coffee, you know, like normal coffee, but cold! If you don't drink it quick, the ice melts and then you have regular cold coffee.
Ice coffee?
Think I'm making this up? Ask the bellboy!
Wink.
Ergo, the witness was not on the scene at the time of the murder.
Wait, what just happened?
So, where does that leave us again? It is my great displeasure to inform you that the witness appears to have been tapping the victim's telephone.
However, that is a separate crime with no bearing on the current case whatsoever.
Her testimony stands. She saw the defendant, Maya Faye, commit murder. No, they're going to let her just walk away.
There's no way I can win this unless I tie Miss May to the murder somehow.
Well, does the defense have anything to say?
Well... Come on, think of something.
Call the bellboy as a witness!
The defense would like to call the hotel bellboy as a witness. There's something suspicious there, and I'm going to get to the bottom of it.
I think you've sunk in quite low already!
Shut up! Who's asking you?
I object to calling the bellboy.
Why? What's your reason?
Because I hold that the wiretapping had nothing to do with the killing. However, if you agree to one condition, I'll consent to calling this witness.
Condition?
If Miss April May's alibi is not called into question after you examine the bellboy, then you will recognize Miss April May was not the killer. Thus, she is innocent.
Well, I know she's not the killer.
Therefore, you must accept the verdict of guilty for Miss Maya Fay. That is my condition.
What?!
I'd better find something suspicious in that bellboy's testimony. Otherwise, Maya will be declared guilty on the spot! What should I do?
Well, we've come this far. I can't accept these conditions!
Very well, the defense will refrain calling the bellboy as a witness.
I see.
You may continue your cross-examination, Mr. Wright.
Right! With the cross-examination. Yes!
What exactly do you have left to examine, Mr. Wright? Miss April May has admitted to the wiretap, yes, but that bears no relevance to the case at hand. Murder! There's no way you can prove any connection. Uh-oh, think this can't be the end. But I'm out of evidence!
Then I believe the cross-examination is over. Mr. Edgeworth, does the prosecution have any other witnesses to call?
None, Your Honor. She's the last.
What? But that means... Maya's guilty? Wait, Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. Wright. The defense would like to call the bellboy after all.
As I thought. May I remind you, dear Mr. Wright, should you question the bellboy and Miss April May's alibi prove to be solid, then by default, your client, Miss Maya Fey, will be pronounced guilty?
Well, wouldn't she be pronounced guilty if I had just let you keep going with that? So, I mean, it's like a lose-lose situation right there, right now, if either way ends like that.
Are you prepared to accept my condition?
Edgeworth, he's got me backed into a corner, but I don't see any other way to take this. I accept.
Very well. The court calls the hotel bellboy to the stand.
I believe we're ready for the witnesses to testify. Also, I just realized I put my band on wrong with my watch. He certainly does look like a bellboy, doesn't he, Mr. Wright?
Yes, sir. I received your summons in the middle of work, sir. I'm happy to be of service.
That tea set looks rather heavy, so without further ado, the witness may begin his testimony.
Very good, sir. I am the head bellboy at the fine Gatewater Hotel, in business for 4 generations. I believe I received a call after 8 in the evening from our guest, Miss May. She asked for an iced coffee to be brought to her at 9 on the dot, sir. I brought it to her at precisely the time requested, of course. And I delivered the iced coffee to our guest, Miss May, herself.
I see. The defense may begin its cross-examination.
Right. I'm ready.
I hope.
This is it. If I can't prove Miss May was involved with the murder now, Maya will be finished!
I am the head bellboy at the fine Gatewater Hotel, in business for 4 generations.
Oh, whoa! Hold it!
What exactly is it you do at the hotel?
Why, anything required of me, sir. I check in guests, I check out guests, I clean rooms, I make beds, I even deliver room service, sir. I checked Miss May in personally.
Are you always so... so prim? Prime? Prim?
Mr. Wright, you will refrain from asking frivolous questions.
Sorry, it was just kind of spoken, like, just out there, like, I can't even think of the right word. I just said it without even thinking. It was rhetorical.
I believe I received a call after 8 in the evening from our guest, Miss May.
Hold it!
Are you sure it was Miss May on the phone?
Absolutely, sir.
How can you be so certain?
I checked Miss May in personally, sir. Not only did I see her in all her stunning radiance, but I also heard her voice. And then I saw them. And I... The point being, I remembered her quite well, sir.
Yes. What then?
She asked for an iced coffee to be brought to her at 9 on the dot, sir.
Also, sorry it's getting dark, but I did have to, like, lower the brightness a lot before recording this, because otherwise it was, like, bright in here. It's getting dark now, though. Anyways, hold it!
9 on the dot, you say?
Yes, I confirmed that detail several times. She was watching a program on the TV and wished to drink after she finished, sir.
9, the time at the murder.
I brought it to her at precisely the time requested, of course.
Hold it! Really, the time requested? Precisely 9, then?
Precisely, exactly, and most definitely 9 p.m., sir.
How can you be so sure?
Miss May was quite insistent that it be brought then. Oh, bellboy, teehee, I like iced coffee at exactly 9. Something like that, sir. Therefore, I knocked on her door at the crack of 9, sir.
Why would she be so particular about the time?
And I delivered the iced coffee to our guest, Miss May, herself.
Hold it! You sure it was Miss April May herself?
Absolutely, sir.
Absolutely?
Yes, sir. As in, so very absolutely, sir. It is an endearing mannerism of mine.
How come you're so very certain?
Well, when I brought the room service, the guests favored me with the... Oh, an embarrasser, sir.
Embarrasser? Is that French for embrace?
It's French for kiss, sir. But not a French kiss, sir. More of a peck on the cheeks.
Why would she have done that?
I believe perhaps she was momentarily swayed by my prim demeanor, sir. It was a moment I shall never ever forget, sir.
Sounds pretty fishy to me. I think our Miss May was up to something and wanted the bellboy to remember her.
It's no good. There's nothing there!
Is that it? Tisk, tisk.
Finally, you understand. This bellboy has absolutely no reason to lie.
Now, if you have any decency, you will end this rather tedious cross-examination here.
It was a bit tedious. The witness may leave the stand.
I can't let this happen, can I?
Yeah, I guess I can.
No!
If I give up now, I lose everything! Oh, you have a freaking conscience now? If I just give up the case, I'd be giving up the very reason I became a lawyer!
Wait! Please wait!
Yes? Does the defense have something to add?
One last question. Let me ask one last question.
Objection.
Your Honor, I must object! This charade of justice has gone on long enough!
Now, Mr. Edgeworth. All right, Mr. Wright. I'll give you one more question. That's all.
Okay.
This is really it now. This is my last chance. What do I ask him about? Checking. Tell me about check-in. Tell me about when you checked in, Miss May.
Oh, all right. Very well, sir. My first thought was that she was beautiful, a beautiful, beautiful person. She's just my type of girl, so it was a disappointment, really.
I see. Wait. Excuse me. What exactly was a disappointment?
Well, I am not without charm, sir, but even I have little chance with her lover there.
What did he say? What did you just say?
Rather quiet.
Bellboy, tell us the truth now. Did Miss May check in with another person?
Objection. I object! That was objectionable!
Really? Judge is even like, what?
Objection overruled, because it was obviously not objectionable. The witness will answer the question.
Yes, I see.
Why did you not mention this in your testimony?
Well, sir, you didn't ask.
Nice try. That's the sort of thing you're normally supposed to mention.
Ah, yes, quite. Indeed, it was the good barista there, Mr. Edgeworth, who...
He asked me not to mention it, if it wasn't specifically asked, sir.
Oh! You fool!
I've done it. I've won! Miss April May checked into a twin room with a man. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Then, when you brought them room service, you didn't see that man in the room?
That's right, sir.
Your Honor! We have just learned of another person involved who may have been the murderer! In this new light, I hold that it's impossible to judge the defendant. You agree, Mr. Edgeworth?
Who? Who is this other person?
Simple. It was...
the bellboy!
It was the bellboy and none other!
Well, this comes as a surprise.
Your Honor, Mr. Wright, it was the bellboy who confirmed Miss May's alibi. And this in turn confirms the bellboy's alibi. He was in the hotel!
Well, sure, if you put it that way.
Also, brightness up, please, because it's getting way too dark.
I do put it in that way, and I trust you will too.
But what if they were in cahoots?
You have evidence of this?
No, Your Honor.
Mr. Wright!
Sorry, Your Honor. Give me one more chance. Simple, it was... the man with Miss May.
The man who was checked in with Miss May!
Oof!
Your Honor! As he has been previously revealed, Miss April May was tapping the victim's phone. Yet Miss May herself has an alibi at the time of the murder.
However, that does not clear the man that was with her. The bellboy saw no one else in the room at the time of the murder!
My, what a convenient little setup. But it's too late.
Too late? I suppose you'd like it if it was too late, wouldn't you? After all, it was you who hid the presence of the other man from this court!
Oof! Upstart amateur! These accusations are ludicrous!
Enough! The court acknowledges the defense's argument. I expect the prosecution and defense to look into this matter fully. Am I understood?
Yes. Yes, Your Honor.
That is all for the trial of Miss Maya Faye today. Court is adjourned.
Mr. Wright! You were amazing in there!
Really?
I think I might be your newest fan!
Oh, I was just doing my job, you know.
Then again, that other attorney was pretty cool too.
Huh?
That face of his, with his eyes wide and trembling lips. It sent shivers up my spine!
If you say so.
So what happens with me? Do I get to go home now?
Well, no. I don't think so. Not yet.
Oh, I see.
But I got a great lead in today's trial.
A lead?
That man with Miss May, he's the key.
Oh, I get it. What happened to Miss May after that anyway?
I heard they arrested her. I guess she's learning her charms won't work everywhere. She's probably at the detention center now. I may have to go down there later. Anyway, this case is far from closed.
Yes, sir!
I'm going to find out more about this man.
Do you think he was the one who...
Maybe so.
Sis...
Don't worry. I'll find him by tomorrow. I promise.
I'm counting on you!
I asked for a full record of April May's testimony. I thought it might come in handy during the trial tomorrow. But now that I have it, I'm not so sure. Most of her testimony was all lies, after all. In fact, there was only one part that got left on the record. Let's see, what was that one piece of evidence? The victim dodged an attack, then ran to the right, but she was caught and struck. Okay, yeah, I guess that could be considered correct. I don't know how much good this will do me at all now, but anyway, time to hit the pavement and do some investigating. Maya doesn't belong in that detention center, and it's up to me to get her free. Remember when it used to be in the corner of the screen? Like the very corner. Alright. So with that, that's the end of that. And I've been recording for an hour and 30 minutes about. So cool. But yeah, with that, hope you all enjoyed. And I will catch you all next time. Have a great day.